Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be an unboxing video of another 2023 Mattel Disney doll. I just got her today and is of the Disney Princess Mermaid to Princess Ariel doll. Just like I said, got her today. I wanted her because I don't have a Mermaid Ariel doll, so I thought she was good enough to start off with. I would like a Disney Store one eventually. I wanted the Disney Store pack, but it sold out on Shop Disney, so couldn't get it. I was going to change her from a mermaid into a purple dress anyway, her seafoam dress, but I got this one at Target. She just came out, and I thought it would be a good idea to unbox and review her for you guys. So she comes with her mermaid outfit. Excuse me, and she comes with her pink outfit as well, and she comes with heels as well. There's the box, there's an image of Mermaid Ariel down there. It says from Mermaid to Princess Ariel. On the back, it just says Free Spirited Ariel explores the world above the waves on her journey to fulfill her dreams. So there's the back. And nothing on the bottom. So, so this is a deluxe doll. So she costs a little bit more than a basic line doll. The basic line dolls are $10.99. This was $22.99. There was another Ariel with the molded on fin. I didn't like that one because she had like this pink strand in her hair. Didn't like that one that much, so I just stuck with this one. So I'm gonna go ahead and unbox her. And that just comes off easily. Let's hope this dress. So there is the dress, which I don't think I'm going to be using, but I will probably switch. I will probably put on her for the video. And she comes with shoes. Pink shoes, which makes sense if I can get them out. There's one. Oops. All right. And there's two, and she also comes with a crown, which I'm kind of having a struggle to get out. Okay, there's the crown. We will change her into her human form in a minute here. But like I said, I got this Ariel doll mainly for her mermaid form. I didn't have one in her mermaid form. And be very careful not to cut her hair. Sorry if you can hear my dog. I closed the door on him, so. Oops. Now, one thing, I already watched a review on this doll. There's only one other review of this doll on YouTube, and I forgot the channel's name, but okay, so, and there's a little image of what she looks like in the pink dress, but we're gonna put it on. My hair isn't too bad, but it is very has gel in it, and mine's not too bad. One thing I don't like about this is her feet stick out from the bottom. I'm not sure why that is. You can kind of hide it with the fins. But I think this is a water play toy as well. You can take her into the water. Her articulation is better than basic line dolls. She does have a jointed head. She has jointed elbows too, and they can go out. And she does have, just take the fin off. And she can't really do the splits, but she can move her legs. So that's cool. We'll take her shirt off because we'll put her in the pink dress. Like I said, I'm probably just gonna, end up switching her back into a mermaid after this is done, but there's a look at her hair. Yeah, I didn't get my Hasbro dolls down, just because this is a deluxe doll, so, the other dolls I have are basic dolls, so yeah, oops, so having a little tough time getting the sleeve in. I guess this is supposed to be her pink dress that she wears in the movie, but, Atlantica, but who knows, they give Ariel weird clothes sometimes. What you can do with this doll is you can wash her hair if you want. I'm probably not going to do that just because I don't really have the time or desire to do it, but there she is in the pink dress. And she, it looks good on her. Almost makes you want to go out and get another one. They had two to choose from. I chose the one with the best hair. And, but there's what her shoes look like as well. But I wanted a mermaid Ariel, so. And we'll put the crown now. There's what the crown looks like. I'm not going to take the little sea star, starfish out, just because it's attached to her hair. But there's, you can do that if you wanted to. There's what the crown looks like. So yeah, and I just wanted to show the backing of the card. It's Atlantica and Under the Sea. But, so yeah, this is a pretty cute doll. I'm glad to own her now. I'm after an Aurora doll now because I don't have an Aurora doll. I really should get one because she's actually my favorite princess before Ariel. Ariel is my fourth favorite princess. It goes Snow White, Belle, Aurora, and then Ariel. But I've been on such a Little Mermaid kick lately because of the live action coming out in May. I did see the leaked doll pictures of Ariel. And a lot of people are upset saying it's not red, her hair is not red enough, blah, blah, blah. But you have to understand that They're giving her this ginger, red hair because it matches Halle Bailey's skin tone. They wouldn't give her the fire truck red hair like the animated Ariel has because it would look off, and, a lot of people would complain saying that it looks like a Party City wig or a wig or something like that. So that's why, Halle Bailey's Ariel does not have the fire truck red hair. But she does have red hair still, so I'm going to go ahead and take the crown off. I don't know what I'm going to do with the shoes or the dress. Probably just put it on my shelf. I do have a Little Mermaid shelf now, so but I'm just going to switch her back into a fin. She does come on a Barbie body, and so she does fit in Barbie clothes if you don't want her in the dress. The pink dress or her fin. But like I keep saying, I bought this Ariel for this fin. So even though I don't really like how her feet are sticking out, but I think it's for the drainage of water when you take her in the pool or, take her to the beach, or I'm not sure why you would want to take her to the beach. She'll get dirty there, but her feet can be hidden. So, you know, unfortunately she doesn't have, you know, bend at the knees, so you can't really bend her knees, but, she does have, better articulation than the basic line dolls. So yeah, I'm really glad to have her because I wanted a Mermaid Ariel doll. I would prefer the Disney Store ones, but this one will do as a good start because the top isn't really movie accurate. The fin's not really, it has like seashells in her fin and starfish and on the scales and stuff. So she has this purple knitting around her waist as well. So not really, and she didn't have straps in the movie either. So not too movie accurate, but I can live with this doll. It's okay. Like I said, her hair is very, gelled. Mine's not too bad. You can wash it and it would go about to her bottom. But like I said, I'm probably not going to do that. I'm probably just going to put her on my shelf and call it a day. So yeah, that was a review on the, the Mattel 2023 Disney Princess Mermaid to Princess Ariel doll. Let me know what you think. I think she's a good doll. Remember, you have to remember these dolls, even this one, are for kids. I do hear that Hasbro is coming out with a collector's line. We'll see how collector it is towards, but these dolls are for kids and to play with, so they're not going to be 100% movie accurate. They're not going to be have a bunch of details on them. I do hope that we do get, I'm saving up for live action stuff pretty much after this Ariel doll, because I do want to collect the live action Little Mermaid stuff as well. So it's not going to be, yeah, so, it's just, she's for a kid too, and that's probably why there are, holes out there, that's why her feet are probably sticking out and stuff like that, so the kids can take her into the water and stuff like that, and, yeah, so yeah, I like her. Let me know what you think of her. Are you gonna plan to get her? I know maybe a lot of Ariel fans would want to get her. I am an Ariel fan, or even though Ursula is probably my favorite character. I did hear that Mattel might be making villain dolls. Now, hopefully those are movie accurate, unlike Hasbro's villain dolls, which they were okay, but they weren't movie accurate at all. They were fashion dolls, So let me know your thoughts on Ariel, though. And let me know, are you excited for the live action? And, yeah, and also let me know, would you keep her as a mermaid or would you change her into in the pink dress? So thank you for watching. Please check out my Instagram page where I do daily posting just of my fandoms, and I always let everyone know when I upload a new YouTube video. And until the next time, please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.